Good morning, and welcome to today's edition of Stephen Whiteside's Stock Market Timing Television. Each day at this time, Stephen takes a technical look at the markets, including the S&P 500, NASDAQ, gold, crude oil, as well as the most widely held leveraged ETFs. This video is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's video newsletter.
Good morning. This is Stephen Whiteside with your daily market outlook for Tuesday, September 29th, 2009. In the pre-market on Tuesday, I've got futures just down below fair value. Golds, crude oil are also down. So we are going to look for some mild selling at the open on Tuesday morning. Now, start off this morning looking at the 60-minute charts. Last week, we had a bearish reversal day. We made new highs and then sold off sharply into the close. That took us down two lines on the hourly charts. Monday's opening took us up a line, and so we're right in the middle of a trading range. And we've got 1078 on the upside and 1046 on the downside. We're looking for a breakout of that range to tell us which way the market is going to go next. Looking at the hourly panic zone chart, last week's bearish reversal day took us down to the lower end of the hourly panic zone chart. We had a nice big pressure zone form. We've had a rally off that. We're still projecting higher here, but now we have an early warning signal up at the top of the screen, which tells us we should expect lower prices. Of course, lower prices would be confirmed on an hourly close below 1055 on Tuesday on the S&P 500 cash index. For the NASDAQ 100, we're looking for an hourly close below 1715. For the SOX index, we're looking for an hourly close below 325.50. For the XAU, we're already on an intraday sell signal. So to get a new intraday buy signal for the XAU, we're looking for an hourly close above 161.50. And for the VIX index, which is already on an hourly sell signal, which is supportive of an hourly buy signal on the major U.S. stock market indexes. We're looking for an hourly close above 25.50. An hourly close above 25.50 should correspond with lower stock prices on Tuesday. Taking a look at my five favorite stocks, even though we had that sharp move down last week, wasn't enough to throw four of our five stocks off, but obviously RIM dropped out of the sky, and we'll deal with that in a second. For Apple Computer, daily close below 180 on Tuesday would give us a new sell signal. For the CME Group, a daily close below 290 on Tuesday would give us a new sell signal. For Google, a daily close below 488 on Tuesday would give us a sell signal. For Goldman Sachs, a daily close below 178 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. Now, looking at RIM, fell out of the sky. Obviously, we got out at the open yesterday. We talked about taking profits last week, and you know, you want to try to ring the cash register as your stock's moving higher or lower, depending on if you're long or short. You want to ring the cash register along the way. And when you finally do get kicked out of a position, you don't want to have all of your position still left, just a partial position. So we took some a nice loss on RIM after making some money on the way up. Now, the question is, do you go short? And the answer is no, I'm not going to go short, and here's why. I take my short positions off the top of the panic zones once the you've got the early warning signal develops, and then the market starts to move down. You get a sell signal. Right now, this gap down that we've got has taken us back down to the bottom of the panic zones, in which I'd start looking for new buying opportunities. So I'm not going to short RIM here, even though the potential for lower prices is certainly there. We've got some support at the July lows, but if you look back to the left of the chart back in late April, early March, you can see there's a nice big open gap there, which could act as a potential target on the downside for RIM. So there's certainly lots of opportunities, but when you're following a plan, we want to take low-risk shorting positions off the top of the panic zones, avoid high-risk shorting positions. And high risk, why is it high risk? Because we're down at the bottom of the panic zones already. Pressure zone is going to start to form. And this is where people get caught when they see the damage has already been done. They get confident in shorting because obviously RIM is a, you know, a problem stock at the moment, as you can see by the price action. And RIM has dropped already, so that confirms there's something wrong as far as the public's concerned. And so they're going to want to jump in and short the stock. The problem is it's already had a major move to the downside, and it's setting up as a low-risk buying opportunity. So the combination of overconfidence by people because they've already seen the damage done, they short now, and this is how they get caught in short squeezes, is because when people pick this stock up and it starts going higher again, they'll get squeezed out, and they'll get squeezed out fairly quickly because they have no profits in place, and so they have to act as quickly as possible to cover their losses or their margin calls, and that causes stocks to rise sharply in what's normally called a short squeeze. So we're going to avoid that. We're not going to do anything with RIM, and we're just going to sit in cash and wait for the next buying opportunity for RIM at the present time. Okay, looking at the major indexes, looking at our market thermometer indicator, we've got bonds up at the top of the screen and crude oil down at the bottom. So for the 30-year bond, we need a daily close below 131 on Tuesday to give us a new daily buy signal. Looks out we're breaking out to new highs and might head up to our profit targets. For the NASDAQ 100, any higher close on Tuesday would give us a new daily buy signal. For the chip sector, any close below 320 on Tuesday would give us a new sell signal. Any higher close on Tuesday for the S&P 500 cash index would give us a new buy signal. Looking at the S&P bank index, any close below 128 on Tuesday would give us a new sell signal. For natural gas, close below 450 on Tuesday would give us a new sell signal. For gold, daily close above 1,008 would give us a new buy signal right now. For gold stocks on the XAU, a daily close above 169 would give us a new daily buy signal. Looking at the VIX, a daily close below 2350 would give us a new sell signal on the VIX and would be supportive of higher stock prices. Looking at the U.S. dollar, we're now on a daily buy signal for the U.S. dollar index. A daily close below 76.56 would give us a new daily sell signal for the U.S. dollar. Looking at copper, we need a daily close above 353 on Tuesday to give us a new buy signal. And our last chart this morning is crude oil. We need a daily close above $70 on crude oil on Tuesday to give us a new daily buy signal. Okay, that's all for Tuesday morning, folks. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Wednesday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.